is Jacqueline Canaday, and I'm from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I published my first book of poetry, and it's called Personally Yours. Well, I've been writing poetry pretty much since I was a teenager, never even thought about publishing or writing a book, but I did keep most of the poems that I had written. And so at this time in my life, and I'm retired and was sitting home, and I was able to compile them and to publish them. I've been writing poetry since I was about maybe 13 or 14 years old that I remember. All of the poems that I have written were written to individuals. And I just changed, when I wrote the book, I took their names out and just made it more general. But they were written to people. This time, I guess mainly, my really biggest inspiration was from a church service that I was in, and the pastor was talking about all of the talents and the gifts. And it just came to my mind that day, and then we were all, you know, talking about what we could or would do. And that evening, I came home and pulled out all of my old poems and started that night. It usually takes me anywhere from about 5 to 15 minutes to write a poem. From whatever I'm feeling that that person might be going through, I don't know, the Lord just seems to direct me that way. You know, I can kind of tell, you know, just what people need to hear. And then he, you know, when I'm writing, it's just like he's dictating to me. You know, the words just come. That's why I can do it so quick, because I don't have to sit and think about what I'm writing. I just write. That's it. It's different to me because I guess I never thought I'd see this day. But then now that they've been published and I see how they've really been blessing people, because I know, you know, when I wrote them for the people, you know, they would be uplifted and things like that. But then for people to actually purchase my book and want to read them and to be blessed by them, that makes me feel really good. It has inspired me to want to do a book too, and also some greeting all occasion cards. The all occasion cards, I want them to be cards for all occasions. And, you know, like sympathy, congratulations, thinking of you, get well cards, and things of that nature. I'd like to write a second book. I've already, I'm like 20 poems into it already, you know, just poems that I've written. And so at some point, I believe there will be a book too, a Personally Yours too. I was very excited. We actually took a picture of the UPS guy bringing the box across the grass and all. And then my daughter, she had, you know, taken a picture of me opening the box and taking out the first book. And, you know, it was a beautiful feeling and, you know, really different. You know, I still don't think I've gotten to that place where I can just still really believe that it's actually happened and it's still going on, you know, I'm still like, you know. I like some. I've been writing poems since I was 13, and I think I was in my early 20s when I received a package in the mail about publishing, but I just read it and put it aside. I never thought my poems were really good enough to publish. And so, and my daughter a lot of times would, you know, say you should publish your poems, but I just didn't think they were good enough. I felt like I was doing what I was supposed to do. When a person needed a poem, I would write it to them, you know, and that was good enough for me. And now at this part of my life, it really feels good because I'm retired and I'm taking care of my mom. I'm a caretaker, so I don't get out and things like I used to. But I feel like being here and even doing this book, it was like a purpose, you know. I was still doing something. And I look sometime and I say, wow, at this age to publish my first book, and you know, it seems a little strange, but then I still feel like I have so much more in me now, wherein even though I could have done all of this, say, maybe 20 years ago, I don't think it would have had the same effect on my life, you know, because right now it's like something I really want to do. I would have been doing it then just because I could do it, you know, but now I think I really do want to. I wanted to touch people. I wanted them to read the book and really feel something, feel different, you know, because even times If I get up and my day isn't right, I can pick up my book and be inspired. So I feel like if it can touch me, then, you know, it can touch anybody, you know. And I think that even having this gift, I never even realized it was a gift until I published the book. I just thought everybody could write poems. Anybody can make stuff rhyme. And I really didn't realize that it was any different, you know. And I never even thought of the fact that I could write a poem in 5 minutes or 10 minutes, or somebody could just tell me a couple things and I could just sit down and write a poem. It just didn't, you know, it never fazed me. I never thought of it as a gift or anything special or outstanding or something that, you know, anybody, you know, else couldn't do. So I feel now that it's a blessing, especially at this time in my life, that I can still bless other people and, you know, and still be rewarded from it. You know, just seeing how they receive it and how it lifts them and how it encourages them. I'll share one with you. I don't have any special favorites. And because, like I said, all of them were to individual people. But this one, I'll just share this with you. It's called Safe in His Arms. Not too stable, a bit uncertain. Close the blinds, pull the curtain. Sometimes just want to be alone. No company wanted, no talking on the phone. Listen to the sweet, subtle peace. No one but you in the place. Sweet smell and savor all about. You're comforted by God's embrace. You talk with Him, you adore His presence. He lifts your thoughts and mind. So you pull back the curtain and you open up the blind. You're feeling great, no more stressing. God has granted another blessing. Know that you are never alone and that you never have to be lonely. Most of the poems in the book were written to individual people, but there were times when I would be going through some things, just like the poem I just read. That wasn't written to anybody, Safe in His Arms. So there were times that I might would go through something and I would just pick up a pencil and it would just, you know, come to me. But at the same time, it would lift me up and inspire me. As far as the poetry, it's just a way for people to receive it and read it and understand it. But I've always been able to talk to people and to lift them up. And I have, you know, spoken in church and different things and everything. But it's always, I've always wanted to encourage, you know, even when I was young, I used to joke around and tell people I was their counselor and stuff because I would, you know, talk to them and help them out in situations. And so I guess it was a gift even then, you know, just to try to fix things and try to lift people and try to let them see that it's not that bad and that, you know, there is always, you know, God's always there. You know, people always think He's just there in certain situations, you know, and, you know, it's easy to talk to people. You know, now I would say that my poetry is my ministry. I never looked at it like that before. You know, people would say that I had a gift of helps and I would help people and, you know, things of that nature. But just from seeing how people have reacted to the poems and how it has lifted them and things, I can say it's a ministry. I think that everybody should be inspired. You know, a lot of people have gifts and can do all kinds of things. And they're just like I was, didn't think it was no big deal and didn't think anything of it. But if you can take anything that you do or anything that you enjoy and share it, you know, that in itself is a reward. You know, if they can just not look at what they can do selfishly and keep for themselves and just knowing they can do it or do it when they want to, but to be able to openly feel like they have to give of themselves and give this thing, you know, and just let it flow out to everybody so, you know, others can be blessed by it, not just themselves, you know. And if I can do it, anybody can do it.